So it's clear, Napa? Divine child is clear? So is the divine child awake?
Yes, yes.
All the time.
All the time. Let us understand what is enlightenment? You heard so many people have heard enlightenment of Buddha, you know, enlightenment, I think that's the key. What is the
key?
So that's all is enlightenment. So you think something big, suddenly some sky has opened up and some light has come. Nothing of that has happened. Okay? Right? It's a very simple event. The divine child is suddenly wake up. Oh, I am the divine child. Right? There will be no 100 candle light coming from the head. Okay? No suddenly thunder and showers. No flower blooming. Okay? Because these are all actually created, images created by you to stories, Purana stories, this story, that story and all. Understand? Suddenly divine light came into, divine light is the awareness. Artha ito ni tharaga. That is the divine light. Nimlakal divine light, suddenly flash of lighting, room is full with light. Nothing of that nature happened. Divine light is called awareness. So suddenly the divine child is sleeping. Ah, I am the divine child. Understand? How it can happen? Only through clarity, only through dnana. It won't happen through accident. Okay? And dnana can only come from the grace of Guru, the teaching, the clarity of teaching. The grace means clarity. That's all. Okay? So it's not something, suddenly something happened. Nothing. It has to be very, very clear understanding. Then you are, okay, this is what is right. That's all. Understood? So, light came. Enlightenment is light came. What light is that? Awareness. Awareness. Oh, is this some divine child? I was like a human society child. I was like a human child. I am the real divine child. The society child, human child, they are all temporary, coming and going. Right? And the understand how they enlightenment. That is light. Enlightenment. You start thinking some new light will come. From this side, the light from this side, light from that side. Nothing will that happen. Right? Everybody? Actually, enlightenment is the simplest and the most silent thing which can happen to anybody. No noise, no sound, no music, no dance, nothing.
We find enlightenment in all those things, dancing, sitting, going there, traveling.
The enlightenment is a very silent happening. Okay? That's what is enlightenment is. See, what's happening is the society has made it very, very messy and complicated because of this all this dramatization, picturization and all. Okay. Enlightenment is actually very simple understanding. Separation of awareness from the thoughts. That's all is called enlightenment. There are thoughts in your head. Okay? There are thoughts in your head. The separation of I from the thoughts is enlightenment.
What is the separation of
I, awareness. I is awareness. Right? Mm. So you have to separate out from the thoughts. So Satyavadi, how can you do that?
Who is seeing the thought? So thought is separate, I.
Ashwini? I'll tell you, I'll very simple technique I'll tell you. Simple practice I'll tell you. Okay? I am thinking. You repeat with me.
I am thinking.
I am aware that I am thinking.
I am aware that I am thinking.
So, anything has two parts. I am thinking is a thought. I am aware that I am thinking is you. You got it? I am aware that I am thinking is not a thought actually. You are just silently aware. Okay. I am eating. I am aware that I am eating. I am eating is a thought. I am aware that I am eating is I, really. That's Narayana, that's Brahman.
Becoming witness.
Witness. Knowing. And?
Guruji, but that I cannot eat nor can talk.
That's sort of thing. That I am eating is a thought.
Okay.
I is not eating.
Okay.
Okay, the society child has said, I am eating. It has taken the I is position and said, I am eating.
Okay.
That is a thought. So now I am aware that I am aware is not silent, not verbalization. I am just verbalizing it.
Yeah.
Right? I am walking. I am aware that I am walking. So I am walking is a thought. I am aware that I am walking is I. Separate out, simple, over. The divine child is separated from the society child. Over.
So when it is verbalized, it becomes a thought again.
No.
But it is.
I am just saying what is happening without for your understanding. I am taking verbalization, right?
Ultimately, you, the I will never speak.
Silent, silently. So you are aware that there is a thought that I am walking. That's you. Okay.
So I should not use. I know that I am eating. Aware word. Aware only should. Aware
yeah.
is different.
Awareness is same as knowing. Okay, but knowing is again that I also use thought that I am know, I know something.
Mm.
So that I know mathematics.
Mm.
Okay, say I know mathematics. I am aware that I know mathematics.
So you should prefix I am aware that.
So but you don't. Sentence. No, you don't have to say. You don't have to do it.
I mean, like,
don't verbalize it. You don't have to feel it. You are actually aware. Become aware of that awareness. That's all. It is not verbalization. That I am aware comes from the chaitanyam. Okay. I am thinking comes from the mind. So separate the mind from the awareness. Finished. Over. That's all is Atmadarshana. That you are able to do consistently, then Atmadarshana. If you don't do it, what will happen? If you don't do it, then you are a society child. So then what will a society child say? I know, I am thinking. Oh God, so many thoughts are coming. Oh, millions of thoughts are coming. Okay, all thoughts are responsible because of this lady sitting in front of me. Okay, so just because she hates me, I am getting all these thoughts. So you keep on creating thoughts. The society will keep. The moment I am aware, the thoughts will stop. The moment the divine child comes in picture, this thought will chop. Is it simple? You understood?
Is it that simple?
Is it that simple? Is the I am aware of the question. Is it that simple? You say that.
I am aware of the question that is that so
simple? Simple. So the moment you go back, you become the divine child.
Yeah, but we keep shifting, no? And that means people, they don't
share
that
answer.
We means who keep shifting?
I.
I means who?
The society child.
Are you the society child?
I'm not, but at any point of time, if the moment I am aware, like the awareness is there, it's not I am aware, awareness is there, you are a divine child. But when I'm in action, I forget the awareness and get involved in, either involved,
No, we'll stop that also. We'll put a virus for that, antivirus for that also.
No, you said it's so simple, but the problem is we become aware after
we
become
miss who?
I
miss who?
The society, the divine side wakes up after the action or after the reaction. Not during
so
the action.
So
it is so sleepy at that. The society is so active. It takes a
tube light.
Terminating so high.
It's very sharp.
Yeah. Yeah. After the action or after the action. But like if you are aware and then you ignore, there is less burden I have. That happens. Okay, the awareness comes
and no. We'll help the divine child, right? The treatment is the divine child. Divine child is sick now. We have to give the treatment to
the sleeping.
Now, Guruji, I am aware that she is confusing my society child so much. Comparing the tube light and everything.
So, please understand. The enlightenment means separating I from the thought.
Yeah.
Okay? I am thinking is a thought. I am aware that I am thinking is a separation.
Yes. Finish. It's a awareness.
Yeah.
But
she's saying it doesn't work at the right time.
If I am aware, then I don't think. The problem. If there it is, the awareness is there, you don't have to think. They
will
not
okay.
Think.
Awareness, another word for awareness is called knowingness. Knowing. But I don't use the word knowing because mine also use the word knowing. Okay? Mine also, I know this subject well. Okay? That's why I use the word awareness. I am aware that I know this subject well. Okay? Otherwise, awareness and knowingness means same thing. So mind takes that also and says, I know. The society tells, I know. Okay? That's why to give a special name for that this thing, I am aware that I know, I use the word. Otherwise, awareness means knowingness, nothing else. Anybody clear today? So if you are able to okay. Nan uta maadide. Nanage nan uta maadide anta arivide. Aa arivu nan. Vedada. Nanu tinde anta arivide. Adu nan. Right? Nanu tinde antu yochane. Nanu nadade antu yochane. ನಾನು ನಡೆದೆ ಅಂತ ನನಗೆ ಅರಿವಿದೆ ಅದು ನಾನು ಆ ಅರಿವೇ ಭಗವಂತಪ್ಪ ಭಗವಂತ ಅರಿವೇ ಆ ಅರಿವೇ ಬೆಳಕು ಆ ಅರಿವಿಗೆ ಬೆಳಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳೋದು ಭಗವದ್ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ 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 ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಜ್ಯೋತಿ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಅರಿವು ಆಯ್ತದಾ ಅದು ಇನ್ನೇನೋ ಹೊಸ ಬೆಳಕಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಕಣ್ಣಿ ಕಾಣೋ ಬೆಳಕಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಅರಿವೇ ಬೆಳಕು ಅರಿವನ್ನು ಯೋಚನೆಯಿಂದ ಬಿಡಿಸ್ಬೇಕು ನಾನು ತಿಂದೆ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನಾನಲ್ಲ ನಿಜ ನಾನಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಮಗು ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ನಾನು ಅಂತ ನನಗೆ ಅದು ಅರಿವಿದೆ ಅದು ನಾನು ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಏಬಲ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಇಟ್ ಕನ್ಸಿಸ್ಟೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಆಲ್ ದ ಟೈಮ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎನ್ಲೈಟೆಡ್ ಅದ್ರಸ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಎನ್ಲೈಟೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ 5 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಮ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ 5 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ಎನ್ಲೈಟ್ಮೆಂಟ್ 2 ಮಿನಿಟ್ಸ್ ನಾಕ್ ಇನ್ ಬ್ಯಾಗ್ ಇನ್ ಅದು ಅಷ್ಟು ಬೇಡ ಶ್ರವಣ ಮನ್ ಪ್ರಿಯ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಇರೋದು ಕಡೆಗೆ ಹೂವಮ್ಮ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ನಾನು ಯಾರು ನೆನ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದು ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಶ್ರವಣ ಮನ್ ನಿದ್ದೆ ಸಲ ಆಗೋಯ್ತು ಅಲ್ಲಪ್ಪ ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಫೈನಲ್ ಒಂದೇ ಒಂದು ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಸ್ತ್ರ ನಾನ್ಯಾರು ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆ ನೀವು ಪುನಃ ಶ್ರವಣ ಮನ ನಿದ್ದೆ ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಅದ್ರ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಚೈಲ್ಡು ಅಯ್ಯೋ ನೀವು 4 ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಓದಿದ್ರಿ ಅಪ್ಪ 5 ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಓದಿಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರ ಅದು ಯಾವಾಗ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಜ್ಞಾನ ಬರ್ತದೆ 10 ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ದಶೋಪನಿಷತ್ ಓದಿದ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಮುಕ್ತಿ ಇಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತದ ಕತೆ ಅದು ನಾನು ಯಾರು ಅಂತ ಕೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ವಾಪಸ್ ಹೋಗ್ತದ ಕಡೆಗೆ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ನಾನು ಯಾರು ಹೋಯಮ್ಮ ಇಲ್ಲರಿ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಆಗುತ್ತೇನ್ರಿ ಹೋಗುತ್ತೇನ್ರಿಪ್ಪ ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಸನ್ಯಾಸಿಗಳಿಗೆ ಆಗೋದು 10 ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಹೋಗ್ಬೇಕು ಸನ್ಯಾಸಗಳು ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಶುರು ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಅದು ನಾನು ಯಾರು ಅನ್ನೋದು ರಮಣ ಮಹರ್ಷಿಗಳು ಕೊಟ್ಟ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಆ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಉಪಯೋಗ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು ಎಲ್ಲ ವೇದಗಳು ಉಪನಿಷತ್ ಕಿತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋಗ್ಬಿಡ್ತಾರೆ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ನಾನು ಶ್ರವಣವನ್ನು ನಿದ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ಬೇಕಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ದು ನೀವು ಅದನ್ನು ನೀವು ಒಂದು ಜನರಲ್ ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಇಟ್ಕೊಂಡು ಜನರಲ್ ಅದು ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಜನರಲ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸ್ ಬಟ್ ನೀವು ಶ್ರವಣವನ್ನು ನಿದ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಕ್ಯಾರಿಡ್ ಅವೇ ಬೈ ಸೊಸೈಟಿ ಚೇಂಜ್ Have you read Keno Upanishad? Without reading Keno Upanishad, how can you understand Atmadarshana?
Go read and come back.
See, the society child will want a way to escape. It gives so many excuses. Now, reading scriptures, yeah, have you done Advaita Sadhana? You don't know Advaita Sadhana? Then what Atmadarshana you are getting? Like that will say. So, don't you know in enlightenment, divine light will come? So all those doubts to clarify, you need a scripture. But once you have clarified, don't need it. Then you straight away, who am I? Finished. Others you start, there's no end to this. Right? Madam, Shravanamana Nidhyasa is prescribed. Shravanamana Nidhyasa is prescribed till you get a clarity on Atmadana. After that, it's stopped. It's not required. If you are not clear about Atmadana, who is Atma, who is Brahma, then you continue. But it is not asked for forever.
It drops on its own.
It drops on its own. Then after that, only one thing is required. Who am I? Atmavichara. So Atmavichara is next step of Shravanamana Nidhyasa. So if you are not able to hold on to Atmavichara, come back to Shravanamana Nidhyasa.
That's the final step.
Atmavichara after that, nothing is there. Finished. Right? Clear, Adrigo? Sure. She is very gifted actually. So for whatever teaching for you, people have only one children at a time. She has two in one. One by one, gotten free. Okay, all teachings are double for her. So, pins. Right? God has such a love for you. So she is giving double teaching at a time. Okay, take it. It's actually called accelerated course. These are all normal course people. Any questions? So, separate out I from the thoughts. That's all. I is awareness. Separate out from the thoughts. Any thought, I thought is also a thought. I am thinking is a thought. What is the difference between awareness and a thought? Awareness never goes and never comes back.
Always
there. Thought comes and goes. Understand? So when you say awareness is not coming and going, that's not correct. Awareness is always there. Attention comes and goes. What is attention? You'll find out. There's a difference between attention and awareness. Okay? So she said the divine child loses his awareness, divine child doesn't lose it, divine child never loses it. Attention goes and comes back. We'll find out what is attention goes and comes back. So your sadhana, if at all is required, is to keep the attention on the right thing. Attention. Okay. Attention, you keep it properly without tension, it's called sadhana. In a relaxed way, have the attention properly. Don't have to have tension for that. No, I have to do sadhana, I have to do sadhana, and then it's gone. Then it's actually the society child has taken over. Divine child is relaxed attention.
Tension diverts the attention.
Huh?
Tension diverts the
attention. Diverts the attention.
So that can happen in any setup, no Guruji?
Yes, yes.
I mean, like even if I'm cooking or doing anything else,
yes, yes, yes.
That awareness should be there.
Attention should be there.
Attention should be there.
Awareness is always there. Awareness never goes and comes back. And attention shifts. Okay, we'll find out the attention shifting. So this much is clear at all?
It is,
I think, example.
What is
it?
Tea making.
Tea ceremony. Yes. Tea ceremony, noted in so, actually, I am making it simple through pictures and this thing. Don't think it's simple. Entire Vedanta Sara, I am trying to give you in one or two pictures and make it simple. Give you example which you know. Say, what happened is I tried to struggle and communicate to people. Okay, many women understood when, the moment I speak of three child, women understood very well. Otherwise, it's difficult for make women to understand Vedanta. Because their mind works in a different way. The moment I give three child analogy, women understand much better than the men. So this is actually, I am learning every day, okay? Is my improvement is there in my class? Compared to last
time. Actually, Guruji, you should have been the guru for Buddha. Why he took all the trouble to go and sit down?
I am the guru for Buddha.
I mean, physical form.
I am. How do you know I am not? I am guru for all gurus, okay?
Yes, Guruji, it's not a joke, yes.
It's not a joke actually, yes. I am telling the truth only.
Yes. No, So
only thing is,
it wonders me, like, why did he has to go all the way to Bodhivruksha?
No, it took for him light a long time to come back to me. Six after 6 years he came. Okay, let us understand. Go further. Okay.
Actually, the simplification what you have made. It is. It may not be understood by many unless it is camouflaged with so many similarities.
Example. The background is necessary to understand even the simple.
Ha! You people have a lot of background, no? You have gone through a lot of circles, a lot of guru. You have read so many scriptures. Actually, now I call it as a, in your resume, 10,000 hours of satsang. 20 gurus. Okay. Ramanama japa 1 crore time. After that only you have come here, no? It's not that you have not come here elbowed, no? ಅಯ್ಯೋ ಎಲ್ಬೋರ್ಡ್ ಬೇಗ ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಏನಾಗ್ಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ, ನಿಮ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಪೊಲ್ಯೂಟ್ ಆಗಿಬಿಟ್ಟಿದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದಟ್ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್, ಯು ರಿಮೆಂಬರ್, ಇನ್ ದಟ್ ದಿ ಎನ್ಷಿಯಂಟ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಆಟೋಮೇಷನ್, ದರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಗರ್ಲ್ ಕಾಲ್ ಲಾವಣ್ಯ. ಓಕೆ, ಶಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಸ್ಟ್ 1 hour. ಶಿ ಹಸ್ ನೋ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುಯಾಲಿಟಿ, ಶಿ ಹಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರಿಂಗ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಟೈಮರ್
ಜಯಲಕ್ಷ್ಮಿ.
ಶಾರ್ಪ್ಲಿ ಶಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ಕಟ್ ಅಂತ. ಅಫ್ಕೋರ್ಸ್ ಮದರ್ ಮೈಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬಿನ್ ಸ್ಪಾಯ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಹರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಹೌಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಎವ್ರಿ ಟೈಮ್. ಸೊ ಬಟ್ ಶಿ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್ ರೈಟ್. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್, ಇಟ್ ಡಸಂಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆನ್, ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ ಆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಬ್ಯಾಕ್ಗ್ರೌಂಡ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್. ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡಿಪೆಂಡ್ಸ್ ಆನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಅರ್ಜ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್. ಇಟ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಫ್ಲ್ಯಾಶ್, ಬಟ್ ಪ್ರೊವೈಡೆಡ್ ಯು ಪುಟ್ ಎಫರ್ಟ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸೆಲ್ಫ್ ರೈಟ್. ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್? ಶಾಲ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರೊಸೀಡ್ ಫರ್ದರ್? ಸೊ ಅಲ್ಟಿಮೇಟ್ಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಶಿವೋಹಂ, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್. ನೌ ಹೂ ವಿಲ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್? ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಐ ಆಮ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಐ ಆಮ್ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಸನಾತನ, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಬೈಬಲ್. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಆ್ಯಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಟೆಕ್ನಾಲಜಿ ಇಸ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಫಾರ್ ಸ್ಪಾಯ್ಲಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ರಿಶ್ಚಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ. ರೆಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್, ವೈ ಡೋಂಟ್ ಯು ರೆಕಾರ್ಡ್? ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ನೋ, ಮೇಕ್ ಇಟ್ ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ನೋ. Okay, so this actually, if many of the Vedanta books, they'll write I am that. Okay, what they are not writing properly is I am is a small I am, that is capital that, and I am is capital. Okay, you don't find any of these books, they are all missing it. Okay, I am is individual consciousness, that is Brahman, I am is Ishvara. So that I am or soham asmi is a like this. This is actually called soham. This is actually real meaning of soham.
That big I am? Soham is the big
that I am.
No, this is actually this. Soham means this one. I am that I am.
Okay.
We'll find out what is that I am that I am, right? You heard of this I am that I am?
Yes.
I am that I am comes from Bible. Okay. Moses, the prophet. There are many prophets in Bible. Elisha, then Moses. Moses went to a sacred mountain. In sacred mountain, he got 10 commandments what people have to follow. Thou shalt not kill, thou shalt not do adultery, like that 10 commandments. Then there was a bush on fire, appeared to be on fire. He asked, who are you? Then the bush told, tell the people that I am that I am. I am that I am is the name of God. in Judaism. Judaism. Okay? In Sanskrit, it's called Swarmasmi. That name is same in Judaism, Christianity, and English, in Indian language also. The only greatest name of God is Swarmasmi. And that's the only meditation which you have to do, really. Every other name of God is actually given by human mind. The God's original name is Soham Asmi. Okay? Bible. Then, Jews scriptures, no? What is it?
Old Testament.
And Old Testament is there for Islam also. All of them, only one name is there. I am that. So if you focus on I am that, and realizing, oh, I am that, actually, all these religious conflicts will go down. The fight for religion. All the other names are human mind. Confusion.
Languages.
Okay, let us understand the I am that, right? Here, the I is the absolute I. Whenever you refer to I, you are referring to Narayana only, because Narayana only doesn't change. I went to America, I am here, I went to Africa. I has ever changed. Has the I changed any time? That unchanging I is called Brahman. Unchanging I is called Narayana, the consciousness, Chaitanya, Parabrahma. Okay? Not the words. What is pointed by I am. Right? That's why Narayana is shown as resting. It never changes. He is relaxed. So whenever you speak of I, you are really speaking of Narayana only, who is not changing. You understand? Parabrahma only. Okay? I am not speaking of thought I. I am speaking of awareness I. That's why Narayana is called Parabrahma or Pradnanam Brahma. So that Aham Brahmasmi has two aspects, Parabrahma and Saguna Brahma. Okay? So this actually is part of Pradnanam Brahma. Okay, this is actually supreme reality. Vedanta, there is a teaching called Pradnanam Brahma. Okay? This is actually here, this I am. Aham Brahmasmi. Okay, this is called Saguna Brahma. First you go to Saguna Brahma, then you go to Parabrahma, Nirguna Brahma, Parabrahma. Manifest reality.
But even that is formless.
Yeah, that's one. Right? So, there is an absolute consciousness, okay? This is called absolute consciousness. So, absolute consciousness is called Parabrahma, Narayana. Okay? Relative consciousness is called Vishnu. Vishnu is taking care of the world, manifest. Unmanifest, and manifest. Okay? The manifest consciousness is called I am. I am. Namale en feeling bartha, I am the feeling bartha, adu is called universal consciousness. Okay? So, why it is universal? Do you have I am feeling? Right? The feeling, aliveness in the body. I am feeling is there, right? So you have I am the feeling. He has I am feeling. That bird has I am feeling. The dog has I am feeling. The ant has I am feeling. It may not say so. Aliveness. Okay? Bacteria has I am feeling. So that's why it's universal in nature. It's not individual. Okay? That universal consciousness is called Vishnu. It's universal, not individual. Absolute is I, it doesn't change at all. Universal, I am. You understand? Can you feel I am in your body? Is it difficult?
No.
No? You can. Yes or no? You can feel, no? It's straightforward, right? It's difficult to feel? If it is anybody has a difficulty in feeling I am?
It comes very naturally.
Yeah, if you have difficulty, there is a very simple way. There is aliveness in the body, no? That aliveness is Vishnu, God.
How does it manifest in insentient beings?
We'll find out. We'll find out. That will come next. Right? First, we'll bring some sense into sentient. Okay? I am feeling anybody has difficulty? That is God. That is the divine child. Is it difficult to find out a God in you? Huh? Is it difficult to find out I amness in you? You are simply aware, right? Alive, right? That aliveness is Vishnu. Okay? It is universal consciousness. It is not specific to you. The fish, the monkey, the donkey, the ant, the elephant, everybody has that. I am feeling. They may not say. Right? Aliveness. Correct? Okay? Are you aware that there is a I am feeling in you?
Yes.
One who is aware is called Narayan. You understand? The I am feeling appeared, that's Vishnu. Are you aware that I am feeling is there? That is Narayana. That's I, absolute. That I awareness has not come and gone, it is always there. Okay, now the I am feeling is universal, it's not for you only, it's there everywhere. That I am feeling in you gets mixed up with the human child and society child. Gets mixed up. Okay? Then it says, I am body. Here. I am body.
Slide.
Hmm?
Slide more.
Then it says, I am body. Understand? So this mixing up happens, this mixing up only, not real. Okay? So this mixing up is called ego. Okay? Huh? There's a mixing up happening. This I am feeling, which is universal, gets mixed up in you, I am body. You understand? This is called ego. Right? Yeah? Ashwini, Padmanajan. So now, entire spiritual teaching is drop the ego. That's all. Nothing else. Is it difficult to drop the ego? Ashwini? No. Yes or no?
Actually, no.
But what? Who says so?
Society.
So
society child.
What do you say?
Easy. Easy to try.
I am. Ego doesn't exist. Ego has no existence at all. See, ego is connecting I am, which is consciousness, with the body, which is matter. Okay? The consciousness is like sunlight, body is like darkness. Can sunlight and darkness be together at any point of time? No. Right? Is there something, a gum or paste can be put to connect sunlight and darkness? No. What connects sunlight and darkness doesn't exist. Similarly, what connects body and the consciousness doesn't exist at all. But it appears to exist.
Yeah, repeat it again,
Guruji. Yeah, repeat it. I'll tell you what you heard. You tell me what you understood, what you heard.
No, I got blank. I got blanked out for a moment.
I am aware of that?
Yes, I am.
Okay, so are you? So, what I am saying is, I am is consciousness, okay. Chaitanyam, which is knowing everything. Body is matter. Okay? Which has no ability to know. So, the two things are joined by ego. Right? It's like light and darkness is connected. How can you connect light and darkness, which are totally opposite of each other? So the ego is such a non-entity, appears to be there. Okay? So the divine child and human child cannot be connected at all. They appear to be connected because of the ego. Appear to be. The ego is not real at all. Because it's not real, no matter what you do, you cannot drop it. It's like shadow is not real. Try to remove the shadow, you can't. Because you can remove what is there, but you cannot remove what is not there. Okay? All teachings of spirituality where you say drop the ego are false. Ego cannot be dropped. Because it doesn't exist. Clear? But it appears to be like that. In a desert, there appears to be water, but there's no water. Okay? In a snake, in a rope, there appears to be a snake, but there's no snake. Like that, ego appears to be there, but it's not there. If you try to remove the snake from the rope, you cannot. If you try to remove water from the mirage, you can't. Okay? So what is the solution?
Understand that entity.
Understand and get be done with that. That's why it said, Jnana alone liberates you. Nahi jnanena sadasya pavitram yudyate. Jnana alone can give you mukti. You cannot remove a snake which is not there. A rope appears to be a snake. I want to remove the snake and then see rope. You can't. The mirage appears to be there in the desert. You cannot remove the mirage and see stand there. You have to understand clearly and be done with it. That's called Jnana Marga. That's called Mukti Marga. You understand? No. I will do 10,000 hours of sadhana. Okay, my sadhana is not sufficient. Okay, I will do more sadhana. Fine. Do more sadhana and remove snake from a rope. I will do Advaita sadhana and remove snake from a rope. You please tell me, do that. How do you do that? This is the falsehood. Pratibha clear? Any mirror clear? Any clear?
Which is not there.
This way the sadhana, for Atmadnana, sadhana is false. Atmadnana only jnana, not sadhana. To come to Atmadnana, you need sadhana. Have you understood difference? Padmarajan? To be ready to receive the Atmadana, you need sadhana. But realization is not because of sadhana. Realization is only through clarity, jnana. Right? You understand? To come to Atmadana class, you need a lot of sadhana. All japa, tapa, puja, everything. Then once you come to Atmadhyana, only clarity. No, no, after I get Atmadhyana, I will do some sadhana. Not understood. You understand? So that's why it is said, you do your puja and all sadhana to please God. Okay? Once God is pleased with you, He will give you, Guru will give you Atmadhyana. So you think that after getting Guru, I will get to God. It is the other way actually. If you get God is pleased with you, you get Guru. Guru.
Lot of bureaucracy.
Huh?
Lot of bureaucracy.
So
we have all pleased God and God Guru.
Yeah. Like that. Actually, people have a very, very wrong understanding of spiritual sadhana. Right? After getting Guru, I will realize God. No. God is pleased with all your sadhana, puja, punaskara, yatra, japa, tapa, homa, good karma and all. Then he will get an Atmadnani Guru. Okay? And beyond that, you will realize Guru is no, God no. The Guru is the God. Beyond that, you realize you are God.
Oneness.
Yes. Because these are all wrong notions which are going in the society.
You said Atmadhyana, for that you need only clarity. So the clarity comes from sadhana.
No. See.
No. The clear thinking comes to you.
No, that's what I'm saying. No. No. It comes from Atmavichara. See, you are actually. ಅದು ವಿಚಾರ ಮಾಡಿದ ಎಲ್ಲ ಆಗ್ಬಿಡಿದೆ ಎಲ್ಲ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರಗಳ ಶ್ರವಣ ಮನನ ನಿಧಿಸಲ್ಲಿ ಆಗೋಗ್ಬಿಡಿದೆ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಟೆಲಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಸ್ಟೇಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಓವರ್ ರೈಟ್ ಈಗ ಏನು ಉಳಿದಿದೆ ಬಾಕಿ ಅಷ್ಟೇ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಏನು ವಿವೇಕ ಏನು ವಿವೇಕ ಆತ್ಮ ಅನಾತ್ಮ ವಿವೇಕ ನಿತ್ಯ ಅನಿತ್ಯ ವಿವೇಕ ಅದು ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಲ ಮಾಡ್ತೀರಿ ನೀವು ಅದು ರಿಪಿಟೇಷನ್ ಮಾಡೋದಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಅದು ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆ ಬಂದಾಯ್ತು I am saying after that. So after that is only Atmavichara. Atmavichara is tumba illa. Who am I? Ashte, reminder. But you alli varbekadbekara sadhane beku. Alli varbekada sadhana chatushtaye beku. Shama, dama, tidiksha, upardhi, shraddha, samadhana, mumukshatva beku. Amele bandmele punanna sadhane madbekandre nimge adu sadhane poorthi agilla. See, Atmadhyana clarity barbeku. Yen Atma, yen Paramatma, Parabrahma yaru, nanu yaru. ಆ ಕ್ಲಾರಿಟಿ ಬಂದರೆ ಪುನಃ ಸಾಧನೆ ಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ ನಿಮ್ಗೆ ಅದು ಅರ್ಥ ಆಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿವರೆಗೆಲ್ಲ ಬಂದಿರಬೇಕು ಬಂದ ಮೇಲೆ ಕ್ರಿಶ್ಚಿಯನ್ ಆ ಕ್ರಿಶ್ಚಿಯನ್ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಬರುತ್ತೆ ಆತ್ಮವಿಚಾರ ಸೊ ಆತ್ಮವಿಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಪುನಃ ನೀವು ಇಲ್ಲ ಉಪನಿಷತ್ಗಳೆಲ್ಲ ಓದಲಿಕ್ಕಿಲ್ಲ ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಆತ್ಮವಿಚಾರದಲ್ಲಿ ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ಆಗಿ ನಾನು ಯಾರು ಅರಿವು ಬಂದ ಮೇಲೆ ಮುಗೀತು ಆಮೇಲೆ ಪುನಃ ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬಹುದು ನಾನು ಯಾರನ್ನು ನೆನಪು ಮಾಡ್ಕೋಬಹುದು ಪುನಃ ಶ್ರವಣಮನ ನಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ ನನಗೆ ಶ್ರವಣವನ್ನ ನಿಧ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿ ಸಾಧನೆ ಆಗುತ್ತಂದ್ರೆ ಅದು ನೀವು ಆ ಸಾಧನೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆಗಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ ಸಾಧನೆ ಎಲ್ಲವೂ ಜ್ಞಾನಯೋಗ ಸಾಧನೆ ಕಂಪ್ಲೀಟ್ ಆದಮೇಲೆ ಆತ್ಮವಿಚಾರ ಆತ್ಮವಿಚಾರವನ್ನು ಪುನಃ ಜ್ಞಾನಯೋಗ ಸಾಧನೆ ಮಾಡ್ತದೆ ಮಾಡಬಾರ್ದಂತಲ್ಲ ಅದು ಸಪೋರ್ಟ್ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ಬಟ್ ರಿಯಲಿ ಇದು ಸ್ಟೇಜಸ್ ಅದು ಕ್ಲಿಯರ್ ನಾವು ಸೊ ಆ ಒನ್ ರಿಯಾಲಿಟಿ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ appears as I am and this. This and you know?
Body.
No, world.
Idam.
But Idam is world, bandila, you know. World is in the idea stage. Idea. Okay? So now we'll go to this. This is called universal consciousness or Saguna Brahma. Universal consciousness or Saguna Brahma. Okay? Now whenever you say God, I am praying to God and all, you are praying to Saguna Brahma. Okay? Right now, let us not pray, but go. Mm-hmm. Right? Are you clear? So, at this stage, the world has not emerged. World is only idea stage. That idea stage is called Maya. Saguna Brahma, Upadhi is called Maya. Okay? Let us close our eyes. Sit comfortably. Become aware of your body. In your body, from head to toe, there is a feeling of aliveness, I amness. Take your attention to that I amness. Become aware of that I amness. Stay in that I amness. If any thought comes, ask who am I? And come back to that I amness. Keep your attention within the body from head to toe, feeling of aliveness, I amness. You can center your attention in the chest cavity. Stay there. Any thought comes, again come back to who am I and I amness. This I amness is present in all human beings, all living beings, all plants, all animals, all animals, all bacteria, all living beings. This I amness is present, and that's why this I amness is called universal consciousness or God. Stay with God. Let your attention be on God. Life is God. Aliveness is God. The consciousness is God. I am that consciousness. Chidavasa, reflected consciousness. I am that I am. Sohamasmi, sohamasmi. asatoma
asatoma
sadgamaya
sadgamaya
tamasoma
tamasoma
jyotirgamaya
jyotirgamaya
mrityorma
mrityorma
amrutam gamaya
amrutam gamaya
om shanti shanti shantihi
om shanti shanti shantihi
लोकाः समस्ताः सुखिनो भवन्तु हरिः ॐ श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः
ॐ
सो ओपन योर आईज सो एवरीबडी कैन डू इट एनी डिफिकल्टी Thoughts come?
Yeah. Huh? Initially it was.
Huh. Then again you are able to go back to I amness?
Yeah.
This is exact meaning of to be with God. You cannot be with God with noisy mind. Just be with God with I amness. That's called universal consciousness. Ashwini? Come back. Right. Sudha? Did you try? So what happened?
I had some thoughts. Again, I
am nice. What about you? Padmajan?
Yes. So the thing is, but when that, who am I? That thought comes and everything blanks out.
Correct. But you have to be feeling that aliveness. The feeling of aliveness should be there.
But that, who is there to feel that? Nobody is there to feel that.
No, no. You can be in the feeling of awareness or you can be aware of the feeling of awareness. If you have become aware, then you have come out of that.
But when you come out only, you get to the feeling, no, I was in that feeling.
No, no, no. Just see, your body is alive, no? The feeling of awareness is what is called Saguna Brahma. Okay? Now, who is aware is Parabrahma. That's next stage. So, when you stay in I amness, it's called Saguna Brahma. Now here I'll ask a question. Do you have a feeling that you are in the body or the concept of body starts dissolving?
No, in the beginning sometimes
dissolves.
In the beginning, when you said bring the consciousness into your chest area, I could feel the chest becoming big and heavy and everything. Then later on, it emerged like I was feeling very light.
No, I am saying, when you say I was feeling, who was feeling?
Beginning it was the body.
Right.
Yeah, later on.
I mean, do you feel the boundary is there for the body or
no,
not?
Beginning it was.
Yeah, no, I am saying.
Later, no.
No, no boundary.
Yes.
And that is called God. Boundaryless awareness. So you speak of God, 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 no? This is God, the consciousness. Now the moment you are there, you are one with all the universe, all living beings, you are one with that. Saguna Brahma. They are one with the plant, you are one with the animal, bird, everything, because that's consciousness. You understand? Now you are no longer individual. You are individual when you say, I am body. Madam, clear or not clear?
It is clear, but I want to also share that just as when sleep is overtaking you and you feel very nice, here also there is a constant awareness, but there is a sleepy feeling.
Yes, yes. That's called samadhi. Mm. Okay? But this is called savikalpa samadhi. It's not nirvikalpa samadhi. Mm. Because there is a kalpane. What is the kalpane? Kalpane that there is a world outside.
Correct.
Okay? Slight kalpane. That kalpane is called maya. So Brahman, Saguna Brahma is I amness with the kalpane that there is a world. Kalpane means idea. That's called Savikalpa. Okay, this is called Sahaja Samadhi, natural state, no force, no breathing, no circus, nothing. Simple, naturally you go back to I amness, which is God. No imagination. I didn't say imagine because they don't have to imagine. Right? So what will happen to you if you go back to this I amness again and again? Silence. You'll become silence and you see God in everybody. It's not seeing, you're feeling God in everybody, because I amness you start becoming this thing. Then you start feeling that I amness in the bird, I amness in the plant, I amness in the all living beings, you start feeling. Okay? It's not imagination. It's not chanting mantra. I amness is the greatest mantra. You don't have to chant it.
His body is in me, Body is in me.
No, you don't. When you stay in amness, the body also dissolves.
Yeah.
Okay? Body will come only when you come out of I am. When you say I am body. But when you I amness, where is the body? Where is the world? Right? So there's a story in the life of Kumbara, Gora Kumbara. Gora Kumbara was a saint who was making pots. Okay? He was, when he was, his wife had packed him food for afternoon. So one dog came and took that food and started running. Then he started running behind the dog. People thought, Gora Kumbara, okay? Don't run, I'll give you food. Okay, somebody said, throw a stone at the dog. Gora Kumbara said, I am running behind the dog because the dog, which is God, forgot the ghee for the roti. So what happens is, the moment you more and more you stay in I-amness, you start more and more seeing the divinity in everybody, you no longer see humanity in everybody. Human part goes back and the being part starts coming to front. Right? So this is the first step of soham. Soham. I am that. What is that? Here, see. I am that has a capital that. I am. Okay? That. The meaning of that is I am. The big I am. Here there's no more body. Soham. First step.